I can't seem to find anything else regarding the legend of Princess Coral. The texts detail her royal suit of armor. In order for the truth of her disappearance to be unveiled, one of her descendants must reunite the pieces and wear it. There's more, but it's vague. A golden apple is referenced, as well as a magical unicorn and a nefarious witch. But that's it. Most of the books referencing the princess were archived by the royal family a long time ago.
Yes, it seems like details about her life are few and far between the literature. Perhaps it's time we pay Chateau de Montrevoir a visit? According to my research, the castle is home to a vast library. The only question is, how do we gain entry? The castle is closed to general public.
However, it is said that during Christmas, the royal family vacate the castle to go to one of their other estates.
Sounds good, but what's the catch?
According to the legends concerning the royal family, a vengeful witch returns to haunt the empty halls during celebrations like birthdays, weddings, and Christmas time, of course. Anyway, we shouldn't have much trouble getting in while the family is away.
You're kidding, right? There's no chance I'm going to risk running into a vengeful witch. Running into one would be bad enough on a normal day, but being a descendant, however far removed, means you and I would be at an even greater risk.
Come on, Marianne. We are made of tougher stuff than that. Surely this is just a Christmas fairy tale.
Either way, since we're delving into the history of your ancestors, perhaps running into a ghost wouldn't be so bad after all. What do you say?
Well, I'm in. Let's make a plan to meet at Chateau de Montrevoir on Christmas Eve. Me and Marianne can make our way from the coast. Lara, you should probably approach from the hillside forests. That should leave us covered.
Sure thing.
Okay, fine. But the second I see floating dinoware, ghouls and paintings, I'm out of there.
That won't be necessary.
Oh, my dear, what are you doing here? How did you manage to walk all alone through that forest? And don't you know the castle is haunted on these days? Not very suitable for tourists, to say the least.
That's why I'm here.
So you might help me instead. The gate is shut. The cemetery has a passage which leads to the castle grounds. Those pesky imps are at it again, and they stole the cemetery keys from right under my nose. If you are somehow able to open this gate from the other side, I will let you into the castle. We should retreat there. It's getting dark and cold.
No problem.
took a while, but you made it. I was worried you bumped into something dangerous.
No. Only a few spiders.
The drawbridge is up as well. We must find a way to the other side. Alas, I'm old, but you look rather agile.
Maybe there, over that rock.
It looks as though you could move it. Let's try.
Perfect. Now to take a look around.
Well done, young lady. I'd have managed too, you know, if it weren't for my arthritis.
I see.
Finally, we can enter. I do hope my Christmas decorations are intact.
Intact?
You see, Christmas here is never easy.
I've noticed. I hope my friends are okay.
Friends?
Yes. They're tied to the royal family, so they hope to find proof in the library. They're arriving by boat, from the other side of the castle.
Oh my! At least the beach approach is safer, and they should find the rear door open. If you should need anything, you'll find me beside the fireplace in the east wing of the castle.
Sure thing.
Lara, you were ages. What happened? Are you okay?
Me? Of course. Taking care of business.
Business? Anyway, in the meantime, we found an illustration in a book depicting the armor of the princess. Alongside that, we found a pedestal that just might be the armor. If only we can find it.
I met a priest on my way here. He keeps watch of the castle throughout Christmas, while the royal family take their yearly leave. He helped me to get in. Perhaps he can help us find the armor of the princess, too. He's in the east wing, beside the fireplace.
That sounds promising. I should also mention Noah found this book. It's locked, and as yet we haven't found the key.
Yeah. For now, though, I'm focusing on where the legendary armor of the princess might be. If it even remains in the castle, that is. If you find anything, Lara, let me know.
Okay. I'm going to take a look around.
Thank you.
word of caution. A large part of the castle's original framework is preserved in many places, like in the basements, underneath the stairwells. Old untreated wood will quite easily go up in smoke.
Thank you.
You should take a look at this armor. The detailing matches that of the illustrations you and Noah found.
Lara, you found it! The armor of the princess, without a doubt. Let's put it on the stand. Beautiful, isn't it? However, the headpiece is still missing. The armor isn't of any use to us without it.
Indeed. And where is Noah?
He has discovered a secret passageway hidden behind a revolving bookcase over there. I'm worried. He hasn't returned yet. I'd go myself, but it looks gloomy and I hate spiders.
Nothing I can't handle.
Before you go, I found this in the hunting room. It could come in handy.
Thank you. It appears that the legend of the witch isn't just a Christmas fairy tale after all. You are half possessed, on your way to becoming one of them.
Them? Who? The creature?
The witch and her followers, I mean. I fear they will be much harder to escape from. That creature was only the advance guard.
I don't remember. I was exploring, and then blood red. That's all I can recall.
It was trying to convert you, actually. Never mind. We should return to the library. Marianne is all alone.
Marianne? That reminds me. I found this headpiece. It's the last fragment of the armor.
That's it. Nothing? It feels like a regular armor.
Unless in the dungeon. I found a key that looks as if it might fit the lock on the book that Noah found earlier. It's as if the pieces of this mystery have been scattered across the far reaches of this castle, perhaps even by the witch herself.
The witch?
Yes, and I'm willing to bet that whatever's in that book, it's important. Something she wouldn't want us to know.
Incredible. Unbelievable. It says the witch Tamsin wanted to marry the prince Princess Coral was trying to avoid. So they made a deal, freedom for power. But the witch trapped the princess behind a mirror. Exposed, she turned the castle guardians into imps, and the princess's battle unicorn into a skeleton puppet. But the princess broke the mirror from the inside, killing the witch.
I guess this is why the witch's spirit is so grudgeful.
But what about the princess? She died?
Tamsin cursed the mirror to steal Coral's beauty and become her living image, which could also die. But the princess is still frozen in the broken mirror.
I didn't see a single mirror in this castle. Not broken, not whole. Either a coincidence, or...
There's a way out, and the armor could be the key. Maybe if I look into the mirror wearing it, I can do something.
Okay, we should try.
Naturally. But let's not stick our noses where they don't belong. We don't want any more encounters with the witch's little pet. After all, who keeps a mirror in a dark, damp dungeon?
Thank you.
Oh, are you here to check the tower bell too? It started to ring out of its schedule. I wonder if that witch... Never mind. Everything seems fine.
Do you know where I might find a mirror?
Alas, no. The witch and her pets has a nasty habit of using them to terrorize the guests. Thus, the royal family had them all removed many years ago. Perhaps some quiet corners of the castle were forgotten about, but I can't promise you anything. I never did discover what happened to all the mirrors. Perhaps the imps got their hands on some. They love shiny objects after all.
going anywhere. Not yet. Your eyes burning like fire. What are you?
I'm the guard and protector of the Red Manor's dungeon. Now, with that...
Wait! I want to ask you...
No time for fighting.
It could be the only mirror in the castle. I hope I'll be able to return to the others.
Thank you.
the one who bears the armor can retrieve the golden apple.
I didn't see you guys for a while. Is everything all right?
Yeah, just some, sidetracking.
It looks like the paintings are trying to tell us something.
Thank you.
wonder how amazing it will be having a proper Christmas celebration in that beautiful hall. It will sparkle, but there is only an empty old table.
Now you will leave this castle and stop tormenting its noble owners once and for all.
You don't get it. I will torment any nobleman, past or present, for I am now the queen.
We'll see about that.
Thank you. mine!
Trust you two to sleep through the entire thing.
Oh, my head.
Your head? I just blasted my way through an entire army of magical mirrors.
That's a lot of bad luck.
I don't need reminding. Jokes aside, are you two okay?
We'll survive. Now, let's finish this. I want my Christmas dinner. Got it. And?
My dear grandnephew.
It's really her.
Your Highness.
You have freed me, and for that, I thank you.
It was really no problem.
Not at all.
My land is not what it once was. And the world has changed since I last walked the earth. I must see how it is now. But there is one more thing to do.
Tradition addition to the Christmas dinner. Our finest Cazaux wine, used to repair torches for the ages. It is known for its distinct pine wood undertone. Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas!
And a Happy New Year.
Many Happy New Years for the princess.
And for us. We will need them.
We still have many days to save.
To the days left to save.
And to those which don't need saving.
Cheers!
Thank you.
see you around good people. Thank you once again. I'm off now to do what I wanted ages ago. But rest assured, your honorable deeds will never be forgotten inside the walls of this castle.
Have a nice trip, Aunt.